OS2 can run Windows 9X inside the MVDM. If it were possible, people had done so a long time ago. There is, however, one feature that OS2 Warp 4.0 brought along, which is said to add some level of seamless integration. At least in theory, had it not failed on me. It's obsolete technology no one uses today, but I'll bring it back to life. I'm the Vintage Collector, and these are my stories. So why can't OS2 run Windows 95 from within DDoS MVDM? As shown in the last episode, DDoS MVDM in OS2 is not a fully hardware-abstracted virtual machine. What it does is by leveraging the virtual 8086 mode of 386 and later CPUs to make it appear as an emulated 16-bit real mode machine while the host OS runs in protected mode. As such, direct hardware access is a no-no, neither can the MVDM switch itself into protected mode, nor would things like direct disk access or access to the A20 gate work. As a consequence, it's well possible to boot MS-DOS 7.x, do real mode DOS underlaying Windows 95 and Windows 98 into the MVDM, but you can't run the actual Win9X operating system. There is, however, one feature that both OS2 Warp 3.0 and 4.0 brought along, which is called Trapdoor.
I'm trying to see the expressions on these guys' faces.
I like that.
As far as compatibility, does it accept any Windows or DOS-based applications?
The functionality is a bit more advanced than Warp 4.0, that's why we'll have a brief look into it on Warp 4 first. For the Trapdoor feature to work, you need to first install Windows 95 and then install Warp 4.0 into the same partition afterwards. It also works with Windows 95, OSR 2 or Windows 98, although you must not use FAT32 but a FAT16 partition in this case. After the installation, you'll end up with this dual mode configuration item here, which will allow you to switch over. Once done, in Windows 95, you'll start into the MS-DOS mode to run c:\os2\boot\os2 to return back to OS2.
Yeah, but that looks a lot like a hack.
Sure, I was showing the manual switchover. The trapdoor can easily be configured from the properties dialog. I've added here Windows 95's edit.com and enabling the so-called dedicated DOS Windows mode. Besides switching over to the other operating system, what Trapdoor does, at least in theory, is to hibernate OS2 to disk and start into DOS or Windows 95 right away. Then when returning from DOS or Windows 95, OS2 would restore from hibernation. This should greatly reduce the incurred shutdown and startup times, though, at least in my test setup on VirtualBox, OS2 seemed unable to hibernate. And this hindered me to fully explore this feature yet, except by means of a workaround. But that's not so much an issue, as Hibernate is not supported in OS2 Warp 3 either. There seems to be a possibility to somewhat patch in the hibernation function into Warp 3 as well, but I didn't explore this one any further. Anyways, the procedure without the hibernation works likewise in Warp 3 and Warp 4. So I'll create a new application launcher which will simply call the boot manager and reboot. Let's see how this goes. And to go back from Windows 95 to OS2, I'll create another application launcher there, pointing it to c:\os2\boot.com, just with the needed arguments to flip back. What's important though is to enable this command to run in MS-DOS mode, as in to force Windows 95 to properly exit before switching back. Now, my workaround was not very well thought of, as it essentially led me into an endless reboot loop. Whenever OS2 was coming back, it would reopen the Windows 95 command and reboot into Win95 straight away. I had to break this by adding the restart objects class to config.sys, essentially forcing OS2 just to process the startup folders, but not to reopen any previously running applications. Furthermore, the way I force the machine to reboot into Windows 95, I'll always end up with OS2 running check disk on startup. At least, it comes somewhat close already to what the actual trapdoor behavior should be. But as you see, it always goes into full reboot cycle, and it may be quite some drawback to lose OS2 session restore capability. So I meant to use another emulation software, 86box to be exact. This allows to configure the characteristics of the emulated hardware in greater detail. I chose to emulate the Pentium 2 from the time, which should give me contemporary power management features to be supported by OS2 Warp 4.0. Once I had both Windows 95 and then OS2 installed, I created this command file sc:\os2\win95.cmd. As opposed to the previously shown method, it's as important to add the /noboot parameter here, because the hibernate command on the next line will care for the reboot. Then, when running the launcher, we'll see right away how OS2 goes into hibernation and then reboots into Windows 95. Now, the method for returning to OS2 is the same as shown before. Simply run the c:\os2\boot.com command from an MS-DOS mode launcher. We'll notice immediately on startup that things are different, as OS2 is loading its last saved state from the hibernation file, and also there's no check disk being run, resuming the session exactly where you have been before. If you wanted, you can add a custom boot message to make it a bit more verbose about what's going on when launching the trapdoor into Windows 95. After all, it's at least some level of integration allowing you to switch over directly from the running OS. Of course, that only works if both Windows 95 and OS2 have been installed into the same partition. This again brings some limitations, as you can only use the FAT16 as the file system. Also, it's not really a seamless desktop experience as what you get when running WinOS 2 natively, so there's no real side-by-side multitasking. At the time when OS2 Warp 3.0 and 4.0 came along, IBM and Microsoft had long parted ways from OS2. And even if IBM would have some interest into integrating Windows 95 into OS2, Microsoft surely did not. There have been other ways over the years to run Win32 applications on OS2, one being Odin, a Windows compatibility layer built on Wine. What's your take on this topic? Did you use the Trapdoor feature, or did you rather move over to the Microsoft world, as I eventually did as well? Let me know in the comments below. I'm the Vintage Collector, and this was my story for today. Thanks for watching, and see you again next Sunday. Next time on the Vintage Collector. While I'm on the hunt of obscure and long-gone operating system shenanigans, I found yet another interesting bit. Did you know that Windows 95 initially included the capability to run Windows 3.1? Me neither.